TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 3rd of February. PM Modi addresses first rally in poll-bound Indian capital, New Delhi. Maldives bans travellers from China over coronavirus fears. And Pashtuns hold anti-Pakistan protest in London and Paris. Now for all the details. As campaigning for the Delhi Assembly elections intensifies with the date of polling inching closer, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held a massive rally on Monday in the national capital in favour of his Bharatiya Janata Party. The crucial polling for the 70-member Delhi Assembly will be held on 8th of February.
Marking his entry in the campaigning for the Delhi Assembly elections, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday addressed a rally in the national capital and urged people to vote in favour of his Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP. Prime Minister Modi highlighted his government's achievements while promising power, water and other amenities to each household in Delhi. He said interest of the country is supreme for the BJP and said, India will not be driven by politics of hate, but by policy of development.
8 February ko padne wala vote sirf sarkar banane ke liye nahi, is dashak mein Delhi ke vikas ko nayi unchai par pahunchane ke liye hoga.
Earlier in the day, Delhi's Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party convener Arvind Kejriwal held a roadshow in Dwarka area and urged people to vote on the basis of his government's work to improve education and health system in Delhi in the past 5 years. The Aam Aadmi Party had won a record victory last time, capturing 67 of Delhi's 70 assembly seats in 2014.
With another person in southern Kerala province testing positive for the coronavirus, the number of cases in India has gone up to 3 on Monday. India's Ministry of Health also issued a fresh travel advisory on Monday, urging people to refrain from visiting China. So far, 350 people have been killed due to the virus in China.
India reported its third case of novel coronavirus in southern Kerala province on Monday. The person had travelled to China's Wuhan, the epicenter of the virus, and tested positive in Kerala, India's Ministry of Health and Family Welfare confirmed. The ministry also issued a fresh travel advisory on Monday, urging people to refrain from visiting China. Two more cases were reported from the province earlier, and the patients are currently stable and in isolation. Meanwhile, officials in Malappuram district of Kerala province held high-level meeting over coronavirus. The coronavirus outbreak originated in China and spread to more than 20 countries across the world in the last few weeks. It has killed over 350 people in China. Earlier on Sunday, the second batch of Indian citizens evacuated from China's Wuhan city arrived in capital New Delhi. The passengers will be kept in isolation for 14 days. On Sunday, monks from different parts of the world gathered in eastern Bodh Gaya city to offer special prayers for the recovery of coronavirus patients. They hope Lord Buddha fulfill their prayers and prevent the deadly disease from spreading.
Moving on, the Maldives has announced a ban on travellers arriving from China as a precautionary measure to combat the spread of coronavirus. Direct flights between mainland China and the Maldives have been suspended.
The Maldives has banned travellers arriving from China as a precautionary measure to combat the spread of coronavirus. Direct flights between mainland China and the Maldives have been suspended. There have been, however, no confirmed cases of the virus in the archipelago. The president's office in a release said that the entry of any person who has left or transited through mainland China will be restricted. However, exceptions will be made in the case of Maldivian citizens. Meanwhile, Maldives President Ibrahim Mohamed Solih took to Twitter to express gratitude to Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar for expeditiously evacuating 7 Maldivians from China's coronavirus-hit Wuhan city. The 7 Maldivians were evacuated from Wuhan along with 323 Indian citizens in a special flight which arrived in New Delhi on Sunday. They all are being held in quarantine along with Indian nationals.
Locals in Pakistan's Karachi have expressed dismay over a huge hike in price of sugar, which has shaken their domestic budgets. They complained they are facing immense difficulties due to the consistent rise in inflation and called out the government for not doing much for them.
With Pakistan already reeling under the wheat price hike, the recent increase in rates of sugar have shaken domestic budgets of the common public. In Karachi city, the sugar rates have reached around rupees 80 per kilogram. Residents complained they are facing immense difficulties due to the consistent increase in inflation. Retailers blamed the dwindling supply and rising demand for the increase in prices, while locals called out the government for not doing much for them.
मगर रेट उसका 80 रुपए तक जा चुका है तो लिहाजा गरीब عوام बताइए क्या करे इतनी महंगाई इन लोगों ने कर दी पहले आटे के लिए इतनी परेशानी हुई इतनी मुश्किलें हो रही थी चलो आटा अब एक साइड पे हो गया عوام ने एडजस्ट करा जैसे तैसे करके मगर अब चीनी के ऊपर इन लोगों ने इतना रेट बढ़ा दिया तो चाय वगैरह पीना छोड़ दे मीठा खाना छोड़ दे सब ऐसा करते हैं शुगर के पेशेंट बन जाते
हैं महंगाई भी बढ़ती जा रही है लोगों की परेशानियां भी बढ़ती जा रही हैं लोगों के कारोबार खत्म हो रहे हैं مزید انہوں نے جو دعوے کیے تھے آج تک ایک وعدہ بھی جو ہے نا مجھے آپ بتا دے چلے کہ پورا کیا ہو ان کو انہوں نے ڈیڑھ سال میں
پاکستان's economy is on a downward spiral for the past couple of years because of massive debts rampant corruption to unemployment inflation and widening fiscal deficit the economy continues to be shaky
Members of the Pashtun community held protest in London and Paris on Sunday against the arrest of Pashtun Tahafuz movement leader Manzoor Pashtin in Pakistan last week. Pashtin is known as a vocal critic of Pakistan's army and blames it of enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings of innocent Pashtuns.
Scores of Pashtuns held protest in London and Paris on Sunday against the arrest of human rights activist and founder of Pashtun Tahafuz Movement or PTM, Manzoor Pashtin in Pakistan last week. Manzoor Pashtin was sent to a 14-day judicial remand by a court in Pakistan's Peshawar on January 27 on sedition charges over a speech in which he allegedly said that the 1973 constitution violated basic human rights. The protesters held pictures of the PTM leader and banners demanding his immediate release. Pashtun's PTM, a civil rights movement, rose to prominence in 2018 for highlighting atrocities by the Pakistani army on innocent Pashtuns and demanding security and protection for them. Known as a vocal critic of Pakistani state and its army, Pashtun has drawn tens of thousands to rallies around Pakistan over the years, blaming it of enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings in Pashtun-dominated tribal areas.
In news from Afghanistan, U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad, after holding separate meetings with Afghan leaders on peace process, concluded his visit to Afghanistan on Sunday. During his visit, he briefed Afghan President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah on U.S. efforts to facilitate a political settlement to end the war in the country.
U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad, after holding a number of meetings with Afghan leaders, including President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah on peace process, concluded his visit to Afghanistan on Sunday. The U.S. Embassy in Kabul, in a statement, said Khalilzad, during the visit, continued his ongoing consultations with Afghan government officials on U.S. efforts to facilitate a political settlement to end the 18-year-long war in the country. The statement further said, The leaders discussed recent efforts by the United States to negotiate a reduction of violence with the Taliban, reach a U.S.-Taliban agreement, intra-Afghan negotiations, and a permanent ceasefire with the Taliban. In Kabul, views on peace are divided between Ghani and Abdullah's factions. The presidential palace wants a ceasefire ahead of a peace deal between the U.S. and the Taliban, and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah's office insists on taking advantage of the current opportunity for peace, which is the Taliban's willingness for a reduction in violence for a short period.
Around 25 couples belonging to economically weaker sections of the society tied the nuptial knot at a mass wedding held in India's eastern Bhubaneswar city on Sunday. The couples wore colourful ethnic attires as their wedding rituals were performed.
As many as 25 couples belonging to economically weaker sections of the society got married at a mass wedding ceremony in India's eastern Bhubaneswar city on Sunday. The ceremony that also included a differently abled bride was organized with an aim to empower the people who cannot afford wedding ceremonies. The couples tying the nuptial knot appeared happy and excited as they followed the traditional Hindu marriage rituals.
जो लोग मतलब फाइनेंशियल वीकर सेक्शन है जो लोग आपका जाति और दहेज और कोई लीगल डिस्प्यूट के लिए शादी कर नहीं सकते हम लोग को एक मैसेज भेजा है सारा उड़ीसा में इस मैसेज के आधार से ये लोग यहां पर आते हैं यहां पर कोई जाति नहीं कोई रूल रेगुलेशन नहीं
ये शादी करके मेरे को अच्छा लगता है 25 शादी हो रहा है यहां पे सामूहिक विवाह है मैं जिसको प्यार करता हूं उसके साथ शादी हो रहा है तो मेरे को खुशी मिलता है
Mass weddings are popular in India, especially among the economically backward sections of the society, as they help to reduce the financial burden on the parents or guardians of the brides. Conventionally, the family of a bride in India is expected to bear the expenses of a lavish wedding and also give dowry to the bridegroom, deemed as gifts to the bride, which could be in cash or kind.
Ladakh region in northern India is known for its beautiful snow peaks and overwhelming passes. Adventure enthusiasts were seen reveling at the ice climbing festival on Sunday, organized in an effort to boost winter tourism in the newly formed Union Territory.
Adventure enthusiasts in India's northern Himalayan desert region of Ladakh were seen reveling at an ice climbing festival on Sunday. Bringing a cheer for the adventure enthusiast, the ice climbing festival at Ganglis village saw participation by large number of students, tourists and locals. Equipping the knowledge of the trick and knacks of ice climbing from the guide and taking the proper protective gear, many climbers set the way for ice climbing. Organizers said it is an effort to boost winter tourism in the newly formed Union Territory and to motivate the local youth in joining adventure sports.
We have started this first ice climbing festival to encourage the youths of Ladakh in the adventure field and also to boost the winter tourism.
And I just climbed this wall. It was really fun. I've climbed on rocks before, but never on ice, so it was quite an experience.
Organized by joint efforts of Ladakh Mountaineering Guide Association and Himalayan Institute of Alternative Ladakh, Ice Climbing Festival is the first of its kind program in the region.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. PM Modi addresses first rally in poll-bound Indian capital, New Delhi. Maldives bans travellers from China over coronavirus fears. And Pashtuns hold anti-Pakistan protest in London and Paris. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.